Could the mood of the middle have an impact on the 2014 midterm races next year? Joining me to discuss, Margie O'Meara is a Democratic pollster who worked on the Walmart Moms research, along with Republican pollster Neil Newhouse, who also worked on the NBC Esquire survey. Welcome to you both.
Hi,
pleasure
Karen.
To be
how
here.
Are
Thanks.
You?
So I'm great. So I want to start with you, Margie. I was really fascinated to have a chance to listen to some of the conversation with the Walmart moms, and just it was so interesting how you know, they're definitely frustrated with Washington. One of my favorite lines was you know, they're basically doing everything we were taught in kindergarten not to do, but they have a lot of faith in the country, in themselves. I mean, they are hardworking people. They are making tough choices. It was just a fascinating group of women to listen to.
Yeah, it was a great project. Neil and I have been working together studying Walmart moms for years, and we frequently hear moms talking about all the daily struggles that they have, just trying to keep the trains run on time in their family. Whether they come from a higher socioeconomic status or a lower socioeconomic status, they have a variety of worries that just to make sure their families are doing okay. But when they look at Washington, they think of Washington as really having gone off the deep end, and that they need to continue to rely on themselves and on their families and their loved ones in order to have the kind of life that they want, and look at Washington as a place where now maybe a mom needs to come in and step in and clean things up, because yeah. Washington is behaving like a bunch of children. They yeah. use that kind of language.
You know, Neil, I love that part. I love the part. There was one group I know was talking about, they were saying basically we need more women because women will, you know, come together and get it done, and men are too worried about ego.
Well, you saw that at the end of the focus groups yeah. where you know, one of the women said, what we need is a tough woman bitch. I mean, you know, it's like, whoa. But you know what was really interesting about these groups is these women are relentlessly optimistic in their personal lives, in terms of their family, and how they're trying to insulate their families from the economy and from everything, you know, negative that's happening. But they were ruthlessly negative toward Washington, toward the dysfunction here.
Right.
But what I thought was also interesting, and you kind of alluded to it, but I think these women are losing faith in the country, that there is a sense that America's on the decline, and that the future really is a scary place for them. Mm-hmm. And I think you saw that in those groups. The dysfunction in Washington kind of comes down to their level, and it makes them wonder, you know, what's around the corner. It doesn't give them a lot of confidence.
Well, you know, Margie, a couple things I found really interesting. One, they seem, this idea of wanting to elect people who would come and work together and compromise where possible and get things done, I mean, that seemed like a popular idea instead of what I feel like we heard in 2010, which was, you know, burn it down.
Right. I mean, you've seen this in national polling, too. I mean, a majority of Democrats wanted to see Democrats compromise. A majority of Republicans wanted to see Republicans mm-hmm. compromise. And you saw it in the focus groups where moms would say, well, just do your job. If you knew what my day was like and all right. the things I had to do, then you wouldn't. Then, you know, if I can't decide today I don't get along with my coworkers, I'm going to walk out on the job. Why do you get to disagree yeah. with your coworkers, get a half day, still get benefits, go on vacation? Those are the exact kind of words that they use. They see this real different set of standards that Washington holds itself to versus what they have to go through.
And you know,
and then Margie, the way they described Washington was in family terms. They described yeah. them as a bunch mm-hmm. of kindergartners or as, yeah. as toddlers who can't get along.
You know, right. Neil, the other thing, what I thought was interesting after sort of watching those focus groups and then looking at this NBC Esquire poll, this idea of the center, I mean, comes through yeah. very strongly. And it struck me that in terms of party ideology, you know, people don't, seems like they don't really want to be identified with a, you know, one label or another,
well, you know,
and that they agree with some ideas that Democrats have and some ideas that Republicans have.
Well, you know, it's really interesting because we're living now in the most hyper-partisan political environment that the country's ever seen in terms of just the partisanship of Americans, and you see it exacerbated here in Washington. But at the same point in time, you have a vast middle out there in terms of ideology and issues. So the partisanship isn't matching up to the ideology and the issues.
Mm-hmm.
So while Washington is the worst example of partisanship, those Americans in the middle of the 50%, you know, kind of seem somewhat lost in this.
I mean, yeah.
there's, you know, I think they feel like there's chaos in Washington and frustration. They can't get anything done.
Yeah,
right. And that's the thing. Like, what is the goal? You know, there's fighting in Washington. And it just seems to a lot of moms and a lot of voters that the fighting is just it has no purpose. It's an end in and of itself. It's just partisan bickering without actually trying to accomplish something to help people.
Right. You know, guys, I found it all very fascinating. One of the other things that I really enjoyed was listening to these women say, you know, one of the things I care about deeply, voting and paying attention and, you know, staying engaged. And it sounded like that they were going to stay engaged for 2014. And it will be interesting to see, I wish we had more time, it'll be interesting to see kind of coming up in 2014 if the middle actually has an influence on the outcome of the election. And if we get more moderate types or fewer toddlers maybe and more people willing to work together. We'll see.
Well, and Karen, these women voted Republican in 2010 and they voted for Obama in 8 and 12. So so they're up for grabs for 14.
All right. Thank you, Neil Newhouse and Margie O'Meara.
Thank you, Karen.
Thank you.